My Saturday morning started with someone sending a message on WhatsApp, which was basically a PDF of the Financial Times weekend, where the opening column has been written by a friend and colleague Simon Cooper, who's a football writer, written Economics and several other books. So the headline of the column is, it's harder to stay sane without sport. So in an effort to stay sane in this time when there is no sport, the 420 Grams crew is getting together to basically take advantage of the fact that FIFA TV is releasing all kinds of old World Cup classic games on its YouTube channel and sharing that with us for free. So we're starting to sort of look back at some of these classic games from, eras in the past, 60s, 70s, 80s. And we're beginning today with the 1986 World Cup final as episode one of this attempt of 420 Grams to hold on to some of our collective sanity and do something social, get together and all that stuff. So Jaideep Basu and Arjun Pandita here. And it's a great sort of crew to have. A Pandit to hai Pandit ji, football ke gyani, ex-professional. So ex-professional, current broadcaster, and Mr. Jaideep Basu, who's a veteran journalist who's covered many World Cups. And, of course, in the course of this conversation, will give us a little some juicy anecdotes from his personal equations with some of the legends that we've heard of and watched on television and otherwise. So, starting off, I'll come to you, Jaideep. For a bit of context and background to the 1986 World Cup final, which was of course played between Maradona's Argentina and, would you call it Lothar Matthäus's West Germany?
No, I wouldn't call it. How can you call it Lothar Matthäus's Germany? Germany. वो तो अभी शुरू हो रहा था.
चलो ठीक है, ठीक है. जिसका
और it is Beckenbauer's West Germany.
Beckenbauer.
Look at.
Fair enough.
86. See, World football had been a game of a team game, no doubt, but individuals have always taken the center stage. Without individuals, football is nothing. Every World Cup belongs to one person. 54 belongs to that Hungarian great Puskas, or 58 to Pele, or 62 to Garrincha, or 66 to Bobby Charlton. If we can keep on talking like that,
66 not Eusebio.
Because Charlton won it, that's the reason. Eusebio's goals were great, but the Charlton's second goal against Portugal in the semi-final will always go down in the history as one of the finest, from box to box goals. He cleared the ball in his own box and followed the same ball to score a goal on the other side. That was something unthinkable. But nothing can be compared with the 86 World Cup. There can be competitors to, like you said, as I talked about Charlton, you talked about Eusebio.
Yeah.
But if I talk about 86 belongs to Maradona, I think nobody will come anywhere near him.
Gary Lineker toh bolenge hi
nahi hum. But if Gary Lineker himself said it later on. But it was called Bilardo who himself said it. When an Argentine journalist asked him, what is your team for tomorrow before the quarterfinals, he said, Maradona and 10 others, was his famous quote. Contrary to actually what perhaps Bilardo had in mind. Bilardo, after Cesar Menotti was thrown out of the Argentine side after a long time, Bilardo gave a long thought to his team. If you look at it, in 1983, when he first became the coach, he went all the way to Spain, spoke to Maradona, and told him that you will be my captain. Let's come out and make a team. And he was ruthless also, Bilardo. Otherwise, nobody would have thought of throwing out Pasarela. He played Luis Brown, and Luis Brown. Finally, he scored his only goal in the final. His only international goal came in the final. So I would say that a lot of people say it was Maradona's World Cup. It was Maradona's World Cup. Even Bilardo said it again and again. Because even before the World Cup began, he started saying it. Because he knew this man can deliver. This man will deliver. But on the, behind the scene, it was a very well-planned affair on part of Pilardo. He built, very carefully built that team. One by one, he picked up players. If you look at 84 Nehru Cup in India, Pilardo brought the team to India. 84 Nehru Cup. Argentina team came to Calcutta to play the Nehru Cup. It had Kareka, it had Buruchaga, it had Nori Pompidou, a lot of players. But many of those players were not there in the 86 team. So he was experimenting one by one. And Pilardo, this is just an anecdote. Pilardo was a devoted Catholic. When he came to Calcutta, one of the Bengali newspapers approached him and asked him, during the course of the tournament, whether you will be able, you would like to write a daily column for us. So Pilardo agreed. And I believe he asked for a huge, huge amount, considering those days he demanded 75,000 per day. In 1986-84, at 75,000 per day was a huge money. Mm. And the Bengali publication, they agreed. They said, we'll pay. And when they came to hand him over the check, they said, he said to them, please write the check in the name of Nirmal Vidar. Mm. That is Mother Teresa's home in Calcutta. So he donated the entire money to Mother Teresa and left Calcutta after that. So Pilardo, we all see as legend goes, we all know that Cesar Menotti was a great thinking coach. He was a communist. He was a dariwala bearded coach who always smoked and talked. But Pilardo was no less than this much, I can say. As a background to the 86 World Cup, it was basically Pilardo's baby.
Huh.
Yeah, it was a lot of interesting things were happening, I guess, in Latin America at the time. The World Cup itself was scheduled to, or Colombia were meant to host the World Cup, and then they couldn't host it because of the expenses involved in hosting the World Cup. So it shifted to Mexico, and then the Mexico City earthquake, of course, happened just a year before the World Cup. So that led to some trouble. For Argentina itself, I mean, there was the backdrop of the war with Britain in the Falklands, the change in government after 76 many years of upheaval, military dictatorship, thousands of people disappearing, all of that going on, economic turmoil, and in all of that, so like the football meant, and we keep saying this, it's a bit of a cliche that we use quite often, but to the fans and the Argentinians who were supporting this team at the 1986 World Cup, the football meant much more than what was happening on the pitch. But at the same time, what was happening on the pitch was a very valuable sort of release from the other stuff going on, you know, neoliberalism, Operation Condor, all of that stuff that was going on in South America, Latin America at the time. So we'll get to the football now. And of course, we are skipping past the game with England.
I think too much has been made out of that game with England. थोड़ा आगे बढ़ो यार, वो उसने हाथ मार के उसने गोल मार दिया, मतलब अभी तक वहाँ पे उसी के बारे में बात हो रही है. If anything should be spoken about that game versus England, A, England at the international level has never been a good team. Okay, until date they continue to prove me right. This last team that reached the semi-final, इसका असलियत पता चलेगा in the next World Tournament if this group stays together. और ये आगे जाके कुछ करते हैं कि नहीं. बट द रियल थिंग फ्रॉम दैट गेम वाज द गोल जो उसने मारा, अपने हाथ से उसने बॉल ली और फिर शुरू हो गया उसके बाद. बट दैट ऑफ कोर्स वाज द गेम वर्सेस इंग्लैंड. बट यू नीड टू रियलाइज एंड जस्ट टू ऐड टू व्हाट जयदीप सेड, दिस वाज पीक मैराडोना भाई, पीक मैराडोना. नाउ फॉर समवन लाइक मी हुज ओनली हर्ड अबाउट मैराडोना, हुज नेवर रियली सीन हिम प्ले इन पर्सन, हुज नेवर सीन अ पेले प्ले इन पर्सन, टू गो बैक एंड वॉच दैट फाइनल वर्सेस वेस्ट जर्मनी, it was, I mean, I felt so good, yeah, because I felt like I had taken me back to a football of a different era, which was football of a different era, but the pace, the style, the way people would approach each other, it was completely different. Even so much so, bhai, that when you start watching the game, what really caught my eye was the old school graphics when they were putting out the team sheet. Huh? Everything, the old school graphics were there.
Yeah, everything about it, man, like the kids, You know, those the short shorts and like the logo of the 86 World Cup with with India, where India is just about on the fringe. So the whole scene was it's quite like it definitely sets you in a different frame completely. So let's start, man. Like let's start with kickoff, I guess, and the early moments of the game and what struck you guys from that build up, because we sat and watched the whole game, of course. The full game, by the way, for those of you who are not yet aware, is available on FIFA TV, and we'll put up a link so you can. So yeah, guys.
Yeah, while making the logs, yeah, bhai, I think Jaideep sir, in tandem, both me and Sidhan, the first thing he said, the first thing that really caught eye was the first minute. He ball throw in pe gayi hai, and suddenly the commentator says referee is asking player to pull up his socks.
Literally.
It was literally asking him to pull up the socks, because at that time FIFA had made it a rule ki you have to come out turned out properly, prim and proper, socks niche nahi ho sakte. Aisa kya rule tha? What was the reasoning behind this rule?
I think shirts had to be tucked inside all those rules at that time. I don't know why, but one need to do all those things.
And
but
one shirts, which was followed, which was followed? Properly,
it you can't follow it always. You can't keep a track of 22 players where their shirts are in and out. Even nowadays, there are several players whose shirts come out after 10-15 minutes.
Yeah,
referees sometimes tell them, please put it in. But while running, you cannot do it. You have played football, you know.
This took me back to school days. Ki school mein na wo referee nahi bolte the school ke bachchon ko shirt andar kariye, socks ko upar kariye. What are you doing, Pandit? Zyada star ban raha hai, hero ban raha hai kya yahan pe? Shirt upar karo, socks upar karo. And to happen in a World Cup final, that's the first thing that really caught my eye. I was like, wow, kya baat hai.
Hey, I think, and if you look at the general demeanor of the referees, I don't know. Maybe it had to do with the mahal at the time where there was little bit of. There was a lot of, desire to control, make sure that, you know, political statements were not made on the air, because this was being broadcast all over the world, and people were concerned that players who are extremely popular might come out and, you know, shirt ko utarega aur niche kuch likha hoga uske. So I think there's a bit of that attitude ki players ko check mein rakhein. If you look at the body language of the ref in that final, the Brazilian referee, who's officiating that game?
He was on.
It's very stern.
Actually, I think because the FIFA was extra careful after the quarterfinals.
Yeah.
Because what the Tunisian referee did was a huge, huge problem. And I think Argentina was not at all happy with the Brazilian referee.
Mm.
They didn't want a Brazilian referee in the final. Mm. So all put together, and Maradona's reputation was made by that time. what all he can do to fool the referee in the final. So they were, I think, extra careful about him. That could be one of the reasons.
But straight away, if you saw the game, straight away, pata chal raha tha ki Lothar Matthäus was given man-marking duties to Diego Maradona. Now, I'll tell you why shed some light on this topic. I think last year, Lothar Matthäus had come to Bombay as part of Bundesliga's plan to promote. So, he had come for something for Borussia Dortmund. And as luck would have it, they sent me to interview him. So, I went and interviewed him, and in that, he was talking about his battles with Maradona, because the press was asking him. And he said, I used to really look forward to playing versus Maradona, as tough as he used to be, and as tough as I was against him. Because if you've seen the game as well, aate hi, usse kehte na sir, game mein welcome tackle hota hai. Mere ko bhi hota hai ki agar main kisi ko mark kar raha hu na, mujhe pata hai ki ye ladka strong hai, main jaake usse marunga. Seedha, pehli baat, chahe ball lage, na lage, kuch bhi ho jaye. ताकि एक वो ना मेंटली साइकोलॉजिकली पता चल जाए उस बंदे की मैं हूं यहां पे और तेरे को छोड़ने नहीं वाला हूं हां हेलो आई एम हियर बट मैथियस इन दैट इंटरव्यू ऑलवेज सेड दैट व्हेनेवर आई वुड हिट मैराडोना ही वाज नॉट वन टू रिएक्ट फॉल डाउन गेट अप एंड मूव बिकॉज़ समहाउ थ्रू आउट हिज करियर पीपल हैड ऑलवेज टेकन दैट अप्रोच टू हिम बिकॉज़ हियर वाज सच अ स्किलफुल प्लेयर that I think if he was always going to keep on getting up and reacting, he would be using so much of his energy that he wouldn't be using half of the energy in the game and going towards that goal then.
Yeah, see, Pandit, Arjun, the thing is that there are two things into it. First, what happened to Maradona in 82 we saw. Even in 83. by that time he was hacked down to the ground every minute. What the Buchar of Bilbao did with him, Goicoechea did with him, we all know. But I think again this comes to Bilardo's credit. Bilardo made him believe that losing the temper won't give him back anything. Yeah. I am giving you an example in India. In 95-96, till the 95-96 season, Bhaichung Bhutia was a very fine player in the making, but he was also very temperamental. He had often been shown red card, yellow card. If you look at 96-97 season, when he played for JCT in that great first National Football League, he emerged top scorer with 14 goals and without a yellow card. Because Sukhvinder Singh, he keeps on telling me, Sukhvinder Singh, till this day, that my planning was to make Bhaichung believe that he can play with the ball. He need not to hit anyone. To tone down his temperament was my biggest challenge. Same with Maradona. And if you look at ball players don't hit too much because their concentration is on the ball. Because they want the ball with them. Because they know if they get the ball, they can do a lot of things. Without the ball, they cannot do anything. So it started in the very first game. If you remember in the first game against South Korea, Maradona was hit again and again. But he didn't react even once. So again, it is Bilardo's credit that he made him believe that he should keep his temper in check and it will deliver the goods. And it exactly happened. And if you look at Lothar Matthäus' thing, what you were saying, Arjun, and coming to the second point, that Germany had done it before. In 70, Beckenbauer himself did it with Bobby Charlton. He checked him. In 74, Barty Vogts did it with Johan Cruyff. He was his marker in the final. And again, Beckenbauer put Lothar Matthäus for Maradona. But it also had a disadvantage for Germany because Lothar Matthäus is also a very creative player, he was. Till it became 0-2, Lothar Matthäus was concentrating mostly on Maradona.
Yeah.
After it became 0-2.
But first half he was winning the battle, sir. First half he was winning the battle versus Maradona.
No, what I am saying, he was winning the battle against Maradona. But Matthäus had other qualities which Germany could not take advantage of. Matthäus was also a very, very, very creative man in the midfield. He used to give very good passes, create moves. But Matthäus was given a duty. It was his hands were full. So Germany missed that till it was 0-2. After it was 0-2, Germany had nothing to lose. They went out. And Matthäus also went all out.
Yeah. But you know, Annie, why I was bringing it up right now is because for both of you, if you see the off-field persona of Maradona, and for all of you, if you haven't seen the film that Asif Kapadia has made of Maradona's time in Napoli, then do go watch it because there's some crazy archival footage, interviews that will give you insight into Maradona, the person. And so then the person is so volatile and, you know, he's a confrontative kind of guy, at least from what you saw off the field. And when you're like that, and then suddenly you come on the field, and when someone is taking you down every 2 minutes, it seems a little strange. How is this guy suddenly made that switch to come into that Zen-like quality of not reacting, looking down, getting up and moving on, you know?
That's what I said. That's again. This is the job of the coach, to make his best player believe that don't react, play your own game. You'll be at it. And it exactly happened. Starting from the very first game against South Korea, Maradona was in incredible form, isn't it? Till the last.
And it wasn't that he didn't sort of try to buy things, you know. So when those tackles came in, like the things that Maradona did with his body and his body language in order to both influence the crowd as well as the referee. I mean, he both bought fouls as well as sold referees on many things that may have been otherwise 50-50. So that guile was there. And like while you were saying that it may have been a bit Zen-like where he was focused on, you know, carrying on from whatever happened. But at the same time, uska dimag itna tez chal bhi raha tha ki in that instant, wo chahe wo penalty ho ya foul ho ya jo bhi ho, look at the number of free kicks the guy has won through the course of the tournament.
Bhai, uska, you know what, if you read about the guy, because he knew he was that talented and so many people were going to use this tactic against him, in training alone, individually also, he would practice how to roll over, how to fall in momentum. एक होता है कि आप गिरो और थर्ड आप गिर जाते हो, कुछ यहाँ पे हिल जाता है, कुछ वहां हो जाता है. वो बंदा मोमेंटम पे गिरता है, अगर आप देखो कभी भी गिरो तो मोमेंटम पे लेता है हाफ द, इट्स लाइक इन फ्री रनिंग राइट,
द होल
कांसेप्ट इज व्हेन यू जंप द इंपैक्ट डजंट कम इन वन एरिया एंड इट्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ऑल ओवर योर बॉडी. द सेम वे इफ यू सीन व्हेन मैराडोना फॉल्स, ही मूव्स और वो उसी जगह पे गिरता है तो मोमेंटम पे लेके आगे जाता है और आगे चले जाता है.
हाँ, उसका थोड़ा वो हाइट के वजह से उसका सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी भी थोड़ा सा ठीक है, वो मतलब गिरता भी है तो नॉट लाइक ए सिक्स फुटर, ही डजंट फॉल लाइक ए, ही नोज हाउ टू एंड ही हैड अ टेरिफिक बॉडी इन
1986.
या हिज सुपर फिटनेस ही हैड बॉडी.
यू लुक एट द एक्सेलरेशन, द चेंज ऑफ पेस दैट ही इज केपेबल ऑफ,
चेंज ऑफ पेस एंड एक्सेलरेशन, टू की थिंग्स यार.
आई मीन दैट फाइनल, That final goal,
you're
you
just
see.
Sitting with your jaw like on the floor, uh-huh. And it's like, ho kya raha hai yahan pe? Of course, and then in addition to that, you have the touch, the vision, all of those things, like the skills on the ball.
Aap usko last pass dekho na. His back was towards Puruchak.
Yeah.
Guruchaga, and he never knew that Guru, I don't know how he knew that Guruchaga will move from left to right. Only from his peripheral vision he just lobbed the ball for him. It was and I don't know whether Guruchaga may have called, he must have called, I don't know, but his back was towards Guruchaga,
but initially for that to happen, and we'll get to it later, I thought Germany was to be blamed as well. पर उसके बारे में थोड़ी देर में बात करेंगे. द वे दे वर गोइंग सो आगे कि मतलब आप अपना जितना भी इतना हाई ऑफसाइड लाइन ले लो, मैं दो रनर्स लगा लूंगा जो पीछे से आएंगे, आई विल ऑलवेज हैव द एडवांटेज ऑफ लॉबिंग अ बॉल फ्रॉम समवेयर एंड ब्रेकिंग योर ऑफसाइड लाइन. बट इफ यू स्टार्ट द गेम और आप देखो, देयर इज अ डिस्टिंक्ट डिफरेंस, एंड दिस फॉर मी इज समथिंग दैट इज नॉट सीन इन मॉडर्न डे फुटबॉल राइट नाउ, बिकॉज एवरीवन is playing that, everyone is training in a certain systematic way, everyone is moving in a certain systematic way. In that 86 final, there was a complete difference in the way two teams were playing. One was playing a very South American, centered around an individual, and people were making runs, you know, and there was no systematic run. So Buruchaga has made a run to get that winning goal from the right, then Buruchaga has also made a lot of runs from the left, and so on for Valdano and the people like that, right? But for Germany, agar aap dekhein, a lot of the runs that were happening is ki राइट जो राइट फुल बैक है वो राइट मिडफील्डर को ओवरलैप कर रहा है, राइट मिडफील्डर अंदर आ रहा है, सो इट्स वेरी सिस्टमैटिक यूरोपियन इन वन वे. एंड देन द अदर साइड यू हैव साउथ अमेरिकन साइड, बट व्हाट दे वर डूइंग वाज एज सून एज दे वर गेटिंग द बॉल, लाइक आजकल के मॉडर्न डे फुटबॉल में क्या है, अगर आप थोड़ा बॉल के साथ चल लो ना सर, ऐसा लगता है क्या कर रहा है, पागल हो गया क्या ये आदमी. वहां पे तो सब चल रहे हैं आराम से, पीपल आर क्राउडिंग अराउंड द सेंटर, अर्जेंटीना वाज प्लेइंग द स्लो वन टूज, नो वन इज जंपिंग ऑन ईच अदर, एवरीवन इज होल्डिंग बैक. And then when that one moment comes, they make the acceleration, tries to push for goal.
वो है वो मतलब देखो अर्जुन, वो 3-2-5 system उसका पहले बहुत ही use हो चुका है, लेकिन एक world cup में एक उतना बड़ा stage में 3-2-5 system लगातार use करना, that was first time I think Bilardo did it. मतलब if the system got credentials, मतलब it established its credentials, it was because of 1986. Argentine team, I think, and he chose perfect players for the system. That is something. How did he choose players for each and every position? He chose players. That really, really, it's amazing that for 3 years, I think he for each and every position he chose his players after giving it a lot of thought, and of course keeping his captain
the game plan was pretty evident that as soon as you get the ball, you find Maradona, and as soon as Maradona finds the ball, we want 2-3 people making runs. Simple si baat hai, because aadmi ka vision hai, he'll find you and he'll put you in on goal.
Exactly.
लेकिन if moving on, sir, अगर आप देखो, you know, in the 22nd minute, the first goal came. Argentina. However, I mean, as much praise as we may throw on the coach and all, Carlos Bilardo, in the first half, it was Germany that was pretty much calling the shots. Argentina was looking a little haphazard. They were making a few forays into goal, which I'm not surprised that the first goal came from a set piece. Because aisa lag nahi raha tha ki Argentina field pe kuch kar raha hai. Maradona was completely off sync in the first 20-30 minutes. So Maradona was off sync. Argentina was also looking off sync. And thus came the first goal from a set piece play.
Yeah, true, but Argentina was on a roll in 86, actually. Perhaps they were so confident. So they knew that let it happen like that. We'll keep on doing it. And I think Arjun, every player was thinking in his mind how to overcome this thing. एक ऐसा टीम बनाया, अगेन आई एम कमिंग टू बिलाडो, एक ऐसा टीम बनाया था जिसमें सारे प्लेयर्स थिंकिंग प्लेयर्स हैं. आप देख लो नॉरी पोम्पेदू, माराडोना आप छोड़ दो, आप नॉरी पोम्पेदू को देख लो, आप लुइस ब्राउन को देख लो, आप वाल्दानो को देख लो, आप बुरुचागा को देख लो, ऑल ऑफ देम वेंट ऑन टू बिकम गुड कोचेस. ऑल ऑफ देम वेंट ऑन टू बिकम फाइन कोचेस. वाल्दानो तो छोड़ दो, वाल्दानो वाज़ अ टॉप क्लास कोच. इवन अदर्स, that means he made them think. He only chose players who can think on the ground. He didn't want hit and run players. So he was perhaps thinking the players were perhaps thinking that Germany won't be able to hold on to it for a long time. Let's keep our arsenal ready, and in an organized manner let us take it as much as possible, then we'll go round.
Yeah, and, but Siddhant, you know, it was ironic that for the success that Matthijs had achieved versus Maradona in the first 22 minutes, it was a foul by Matthijs on Maradona on the right side that led to that foul. Set piece, ball put in, and Argentina take the first goal.
Are we pausing here for the goal?
No, you can't pause for the goal, bhai. You'll have to run it as a screen. Nahi to wo copyright kar denge aapko.
Yeah, so and we talk about this quite often, about goalkeeping and decision making. Because the keeper jumping out of, coming off his line, hoping to grab that ball, completely missing the ball. And then leaving it wide open for, as Jaydeep mentioned, Jose Luis Brown, who had mixed Irish and Argentinian heritage, scoring his first and only goal for Argentina in a World Cup final. I mean, what's the guy's name? Lilian Thuram in the semi-final of the 1998 World Cup, many years later, would go on to do. But goalkeeping error, great ball in from Maradona, obviously. The whip on that ball, like, I guess he also figured where the keeper might decide to come and grab the ball, and the ball wasn't there for Schumacher, who was considered probably one of the top goalkeepers in the world at that time.
But you know, I was also loving the commentary, by the way. There was a certain relaxed nature to the commentary and the way the sound was coming out, because it was a little distorted. मेरे को तो बहुत पसंद आ रहा है. इट्स लाइक दिस न्यू एज थिंग ऑफ लविंग वाइनल साउंड, राइट, व्हिच इज कमिंग बैक इनटू फैशन. दैट काइंड ऑफ साउंड वाज अ लिटिल, थोड़ा सा
लिटिल बिट ऑफ क्रैकल टाइप.
हां, थोड़ा सा क्रैकल था उसमें. एंड द कमेंटेटर्स, इफ यू वर नोटिसिंग, दे वर नॉट होल्डिंग बैक. आपने कहा पॉलिटिकली चीजें नहीं बोल रहे थे, बट व्हेन इट केम टू क्रिटिसाइजिंग द प्लेयर्स, हां, एंड अगेन टॉकिंग अबाउट समवन नॉट डूइंग समथिंग, सो लाइक, बट व्हेन ऑफ कोर्स द गोलकीपर मेड दैट एरर ऑफ जजमेंट, दे केप्ट ऑन क्रिटिसाइजिंग हिम फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स ऑफ द गेम, दैट दिस एरर ऑफ जजमेंट हैज लेड टू द फर्स्ट गोल इन द वर्ल्ड कप फाइनल.
नो, क्रिटिसाइजिंग, सो कमेंटेटर्स क्रिटिसाइजिंग प्लेयर्स, प्लेयर्स आर सीम टू बी द ओनली पार्टी व्हिच कमेंटेटर्स आर स्टिल अलाउड टू क्रिटिसाइज. क्रिकेट की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं ना, क्रिकेट में सीन अलग है, क्योंकि वो बीसीसीआई के प्लेयर हैं और बीसीसीआई के कमेंटेटर हैं, तो अलग सीन हो जाता है. लेकिन बाकी अगर आप देखें, और आईएसएल की भी बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि वहां भी थोड़ा अलग सीन है. लेकिन
आईसीसी वर्ल्ड कप की बात कर लो, माइकल रेफरी को पत्र मिल गया था आईसीसी से.
नहीं, तो वो क्रिकेट पे जा रहे हैं ना, क्रिकेट का थोड़ा अलग कहानी है. बट आप फुटबॉल को अगर देखें तो रेफरीज को क्रिटिसाइज करना थोड़ा आजकल अलाउड नहीं है, सिस्टम या जो ऑर्गेनाइजर्स वगैरह हैं उनको क्रिटिसाइज करना अलाउड नहीं है. तो द ओनली पार्टी दैट यू कैन रियली क्रिटिसाइज स्टिल फॉर मेकिंग मिस्टेक्स, फॉर मिसिंग अ गोल, फॉर प्ले एक्टिंग, फॉर वॉट एवर एल्स दे माइट बी डूइंग ऑन द पिच आर द प्लेयर्स. So and so it's interesting, and maybe we can talk a little bit about this because the 86 World Cup also kind of was the big television World Cup when I think Eduardo Galeano said it, where stadiums became gigantic television studios. In fact, and you're looking even Maradona and the Argentinians, I think were highly critical of this, that some of the key games were played at noon under the blazing sun in Mexico, because noon in Mexico would make it prime time viewing for European audiences, to catch those games. And that came in for
It
heavy
happened in
criticism.
USA also, man. It happened in 94 also, the
Yeah.
same
But
thing.
then going forward, yeah. So I'm saying, what I was saying is this is the first time perhaps that because of television, all of these things came into play as well. So that way, it was quite a seminal World Cup there, from Mexican Wave se lege, which is also probably a television phenomena. नहीं तो स्टेडियम में वेव करने का कोई मतलब नहीं है अगर आपके पास वो कैमरास नहीं है दिखाने के लिए कैसा लगता है. तो वो भी है. या सो डेफिनेटली द कमेंटेटर्स, आई मीन इट्स आल्सो लाइक इट वाज वेरी डिफरेंट. From I was glad that there was no England in the World Cup final, because listening to English
English
commentators
commentators and
like वो उनका पूरा मतलब सीन ही खराब हो जाता है. लाइक हम
it's like India
इंग्लिश
cricket only.
दिस
लेकिन इंग्लैंड तो हैज ओनली वंस 1966 आफ्टर दैट तो नहीं, बिफोर
नो
एंड आफ्टर.
जयदीप सर, बट सिंस वी आर
हाँ
टॉकिंग ऑन द कमेंटेटर, उसने हाफ टाइम में बड़ी प्यारी चीज बोली मैराडोना के बारे में. बिकॉज क्या हो रहा था, फर्स्ट 35 odd minutes मैराडोना कुछ कर नहीं पा रहा था. सो ही वाज ट्राइंग टू डू टू मच, राइट? ही वाज ट्राइंग टू ड्रिबल अबाउट टू थ्री प्लेयर्स, बट कोई मथेस आ रहा था, मथेस ही वाज गेटिंग द बेटर ऑफ, देन समवन एल्स वाज कमिंग एंड टेकिंग हिम डाउन. सो एंड देन जस्ट आई थिंक 5 minutes बिफोर हाफ टाइम व्हाट मैराडोना हैड स्टार्टेड डूइंग वाज कि ही रियलाइज कि ये मेरे को अटैक करने वाले हैं बहुत जल्दी, तो गेटिंग द बॉल फर्स्ट टच, मूविंग इन एंड गेटिंग इन हिज टीम इनटू द गेम, राइट? सो एज द अर्जेंटीना वाज वॉकिंग ऑफ एट हाफ टाइम, कमेंटेटर सेज Maradona's biggest challenge in this World Cup final is to find a balance between being a team player and his individual brilliance. I thought that was such a nice thing he said, you know, and that is such a tough one because when you're so so talented that you know you can go past at least 5-6 players, agar mera din raha, mera momentum raha mere saath mein, par fir dusra ye nazariya hai ki agar main 5-6 player ko har bari kaatne ki koshish karunga to mere 9 khiladi kya karenge, fir wahan pe thenga karenge.
Haan wo to hai hai, but he has been doing it against England, like Valdano, or who said, Buruchaga said, or Valdano said that he kept on waiting for the ball to come, but it never came. And he Valdano, and he says he's glad it never came.
Yeah. So, I think Enrique also made a good one. Na, sarcastically he said, "Ki pass to kya hi diya tha? Usne apne half mein pass diya tha usko." तो ही सेड कि ऐसा पास मैंने दिया, इफ ही हैड नॉट स्कोर्ड दैट गोल तो मतलब वी वुड हैव बीन शॉक्ड.
या वल्दानो सेड दैट आई केप्ट ऑन वेटिंग दैट ही विल गिव इट टू मी, ही विल गिव इट एंड ही नेवर गिव इट,
आई थिंक,
एंड आई एम ग्लैड ही नेवर गिव इट.
आई थिंक वल्दानो एंड दिस इज एंड वल्दानो एंड मैराडोना वर नॉट टू प्लेयर्स हु वर द बेस्ट ऑफ फ्रेंड्स, दे डिडंट रियली गेट अलोंग. आई थिंक मैराडोना डिडंट लाइक वल्दानो सो मच एज अ
Maradona didn't
player.
Like even I think Buruchaga was not a great friend of Maradona, but Valdano said the best thing.
He
Valdano
wasn't a good teammate.
But see, I think they were playing in Colombia, and in Colombia they lost a match to national club or somebody. That was before the World Cup, and there was a lot of problems in the team. Then they had a 3-hour session. Lado had a 3-hour session with the players, and they thrashed out a lot of things. And they decided not to play any more friendly game. Let's go to Mexico straight away. And some people said that the team arrived in Mexico a bit undercooked. Some people felt. later it was proved that they were right, that they didn't play well. When you win the cup, everything is right, of course. But I like the Valdano comment. Valdano said, ki, I can, the goal Maradona scored against England, I can describe it much better than Maradona, but I cannot score, of course, like it. So that way, when you have so many great players in the team, you must be having some problems or the other, somewhere. Mm. But how to manage it is the biggest challenge, isn't it? Maybe in the Indian cricket team also, I get to hear, I don't know how right, that a lot of players have problems with a lot of players. They don't like each other. But it doesn't matter when you have
Team, sir. Team dynamics are pretty much the same. If you're humans, when you have 11 humans vying for a spot, you know, and 11 humans and one is standing out, two are really standing out in a performance, you're bound to have ego issues. You're bound to have people talking behind closed doors. Or you know, you're sort of letting loose and jo aapko lag raha hai kisi aur ko jaake bata rahe ho wo kisi, ye to hona hi hai team dynamics mein, choti team ho badi team ho baat ek hi hai. And as far as Maradona, I've always heard he's not been a very liked teammate, you know, purely because outside of the team, ek to, you know, during the game he is doing what he's doing, and then you have another guy who's probably the seventh best player in the country. Who's saying, yeah, ye to ball leke chale ja raha hai, kare ja raha hai, ye to mere ko ball pass hi nahi karta hai. So then he's, of course, bound to get a little jealous and angry with the guy, man. And off the field also, you know, whatever he was doing, not coming for training, or, you know, his late night dress in Italy, and so on. So, I mean, I'm not surprised that Maradona was not a very liked teammate. Though he was probably the most loved footballer in the world ever. But as far as being a teammate, I don't think he was liked very much.
I don't know whether it's just, pata nahi hai, maybe Jaideep probably knows more about the players at that time and what they had to say about Maradona. So,
but I will give you one small incident which I shared with Sidhan the other day when we were talking. In 2010 World Cup, in the Argentine team was based in Pretoria. They were holding the press conference every day at Pretoria. And that was under the वो सीढ़ियाँ के नीचे घर कमरा होता था बिंजी टाइप का वो जैसे कि अंबेडकर स्टेडियम के नीचे जो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस हो रहा है ऐसा टाइप का थोड़ा बड़ा है ऑफ कोर्स नॉट टू बिग ऑफ कोर्स तो उसमें माराडोना रोज प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करते थे तो लोग रोज जाते थे तो ही वाज द अर्जेंटाइन कोच एट दैट टाइम सो आई रिमेंबर वन डे वन फेलो आस्क्ड अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम बिहाइंड एंड ही आस्क्ड इट इन इटालियन And where the Maradona and his teammates and his other staff will sit, that place used to be kept under a barrier with a rope, nothing else. Maybe a couple of chairs were put in front of him so that nobody can approach immediately. So from behind, he asked it in Italian. So I don't know what he asked. I can't. Maradona looked at him and he jumped out of his chair. He jumped over the barricade and jostled through the journalist and went and hugged that journalist. And he looked so happy. He started asking him something. So nobody could understand what was happening. So later on, it was found the journalist who asked that question was a 1986 Napoli third goalkeeper. So he was meeting Maradona after a long time. He was a third goalkeeper. He never played a match and later became a journalist. So Maradona was so happy looking at his teammate that he threw all caution to win. Right? And it was so spontaneous that I really liked it because of his I could guess that he's smiling. It's not artificial. He's genuinely happy looking at his old colleague.
So, that further reiterates my point, sir. What I'm trying to say. See, if Joe aapne kahani batai, there's no doubt about that. The Maradona is someone who thinks from the heart and not from the head, right? But that person is the third goalkeeper. I am talking about a player who's in the playing 11, who's seeing your playing 11 player do that. The psyche is such that if you see another guy try to act like he's away from this world, he's completely different and everything runs according to him. Jo playing 11 ka player hai na, who's competing with him day in, day out for a spot in the playing 11, kahin na kahin uske ghar mein, uske dil mein na, dile shikwe hoenge kuch na kuch. Har vakt honge. And they'll always refer to him as a bad teammate, not a happy teammate. It's the same thing with Zlatan Ibrahimovic right now. The smallest of things. His time in LA Galaxy, for as successful as it was, jisne bade goal mare hain sir wahan pe LA Galaxy mein, and he goes out in the press and he speaks the way he does, talks the talk, walks the walk as well. But now, 1 year since moving on from LA Galaxy, within the space of, I think, 4 weeks or something, at least 5 players have come out and started criticizing him. He was too big for his boots, he used to say too much, he used to push us around, you know. And that is the general psyche of a first 11 player when talking about another first 11 player.
Achhi, we won't ever know the names of those 5 players.
Only thing is that I don't think Maradona has ever been accused of such thing. Even Valdano, who never liked Maradona, he said he was a great player, but his current life is trying to put up a show. He's leading it like a show, which will not do any good to him. The only thing Valdano had to say about Maradona, that is also about the current Maradona. Maradona, yeah, of course, but he never criticized his colleagues in front of others, at least not in 86, if you remember. And he never tried to bring down his visibly inferior colleagues in the front of others also, which I feel. Well, many of his colleagues were visibly inferior to him. And it's like writing, you write 1 lakh somewhere, 1000000, 7 digits zeros, and you remove that one, that rest of the 7 will have left with no meaning. So Maradona was like that in that team, perhaps.
But you know what, sir, in the Napoli, sorry, Andy, in the Napoli film that Asif Kapadia had made, and in that they show he's getting ready for the 86 World Cup as well. And he works with his Italian trainer, personal Italian trainer who he has, and who he places a lot of faith and trust in. Yeah. So, and you know, so he opens up to him, because generally kya hota hai, when you have that bigger personality, sometimes because so many people are trying to get a piece of you, you shut yourself out. And you only open yourself up to a few people who you believe in or you have faith in, you know. So he opened himself up to him. And that trainer said there are two sides to Maradona. There is one Diego, the young boy who loves his football, who's very loving, who's very passionate and who cares about everyone in his family circle. And then there is a Maradona, which is this avatar that has been painted not just by the world, but also by Maradona. And, you know, the partying, the going out. And so the two... just, you know, he's always trying to bring the two together, but somehow the Maradona has always been overpowering the Diego, probably post 86-87, because then hota kya hai ki aap itne bade player ho and you are loved a lot, but then started the scandals, the cocaine and the doping, yeah, and so on. So then you sort of develop an attitude, it's me against the world, you know. Aur wo fir usko aage usko badhawa dete rehta. In fact, if anyone wants to watch a very nice Maradona film on Netflix, there's a film of what he was doing coaching a team in Mexico. And he spent a lot of time with those boys. And so these were boys who were like, it's basically like saying, Bhaichung Bhutia is playing with me and Siddhant. Right? And he's coaching us. So it's that gap, that bigger gap, right? And then you have someone like Maradona there, and the love that he was showing to those boys and the way he was pumping them all in the dressing room, and the way he was really, really motivating them to go out and do well. And he was pretty successful in his first year. It's a really nice watch if anyone wants to go there. I've forgotten the name of the film. But Netflix pe hai, aapko mil jayega.
So, isi baat pe referee will raise aur VCT to hai nahi bajane ke liye, lekin 45 minute aur plus injury time ho chuka hai. So, unless hamara ye idea hai ki hum 90 minute ki commentary karenge is 90 minute ki game pe. हमें थोड़ा आगे गाड़ी को बढ़ाना चाहिए।
हाँ भाई, थोड़ा मैं आगे बढ़ा दूँ। अगर can I just bring it up to a point where 2-0, so you're thinking, okay, Argentina has won this game, done and dusted, Argentina is taking the World Cup home. But then with about 7-8 minutes, if you pulled it back to 2-2, I think the advantage is with Germany, right? West Germany, the advantage is totally with West Germany.
Within 10 minutes.
Which is why I was so surprised that they were playing such a high line. So if I am the coach, and I'm not saying ki main Beckenbauer ke kya kar raha hai, main ye ko dalte hain wahan pe, but main simple si baat kar raha hu. If Beckenbauer is the coach, आपने टू ऑल वहां पे कर दिया, 7 मिनट बाकी है और आप पेनल्टीज पे जा रहे हो। सर मैं पेनल्टीज की वेट करूंगा, मैं पीछे रहूंगा यार। जो सर बोरुशागर ने जो गोल मारा है, डिड यू सी व्हाट द जर्मन डिफेंस वाज, दे वर राइट नियर द हाफ लाइन। तब उसने मैराडोना ऑफ कोर्स,
but germany was going for offside trap at that time.
Yeah, they were so taking, that's taking my point. Why were you going for the offside trap with 6 minutes because to go, and you already equalized?
Because they were afraid of one man, that is the reason. They were actually afraid of that man still that time. That was the reason. That's why they were going for offside trap.
It's strange, because then if you take it down to penalties, that one man can only contribute one goal, then it boils down to the other 9 people as well and your goalkeeper. So I was a little baffled by that decision.
Yeah, that is there. But again, they were all afraid of him at that time. Even sitting in 2020, we can't perhaps imagine how much scared they were of him, because only 4 days back, what he has done is something amazing. If he can do it again, instead of 6, if he can dribble 3, that is enough, isn't it? So that was perhaps the reason why they were not taking any chance and going for that.
Offside
man marking situation, basically.
But bhai, just imagine any the pressure on someone like a Bhurushaga. See, ek hota hai ki. There are about 3 minutes remaining in a game. Aapko ball at your feet mili and you've taken a shot aur aapne achha kiya. He's played him in for half line.
Yeah.
He's ran with the ball. So he's had time to think. He's going in on goal. And then with 3 minutes to go, he's probably attacking the goal for that one final shot that could win the World Cup. Mm-hmm. And he placed it perfectly fine. Because when you're shown in football, ki aap agar right se ja rahe ho, usne left mein low mara ekdam.
Through the legs as he's coming out, it's a perfectly finished. I mean, both the finishes, if you look at.
Perhaps because a few of the German defenders was thinking that he will give it to Valdano, which he didn't give. Valdano was, I think, was shouting for the ball also.
No, he kept on shouting. It was Valdano who scored the previous one, right? Which was from the opposite side across Schumacher in the other corner. Another perfect finish. Again, where there was time for him to think about where to put the ball, whether to go near post, far post, across the goalkeeper or the other way. You know, perfect finish. I mean, and remarkable under that, in that pressure situation, which, of course, none of us perhaps will feel that kind of pressure in
massive
our lives.
Pressure, yeah. Massive pressure, massive pressure.
World Cup final and a World Cup final where you are... You know, you are coming from a place where you are coming, where it supposedly means so much to you, and where you have the greatest player in the world finally trying to establish himself as the greatest player in the world. It means so much to your fans. And you're playing against a West Germany team, which is in the final for second time on the trot, trying to establish itself as perhaps one of the greatest teams to play this game, over the ages. So all of those things, and in those circumstances, to have I mean, and this with like a couple of minutes to go on the clock, it just shows how, what level, like Jaideep was saying, the confidence and the kind of like mental level that this Argentina team was at, just something else. But also I want to just bring up quickly, whether it was especially in the first half, you're saying like Maradona didn't have or wasn't able to do much for large stretches of the game. You look at the intensity with which the Germans were pressing on the ball, right? When whoever had the ball, it took a couple of seconds only for the man to be on, like boom, boom. And some of the tackles that were going in, even when you thought that the Germans were beaten, suddenly there would be this tackle that would come in, last minute tackle, last ditch tackle, but perfectly timed. So I just wanted to bring up something from Schumacher's book, actually, which came out a couple of years later.
And you have it?
It brings up the dark side of the game. The book is called, one second, let me just bring it up now. One second. Huh?
भाई हाउ कैन यू, पहले एक बार आपके पास ये किताब कैसे है ये बताइए आप गोलकीपर का कीड़ा आपके अंदर कहां से है
कीड़ा So the book is called The Starting Whistle. Basically, he talks about generally like, and many players, I think you had brought up earlier, sir, the 1954 World Cup, right? And Puskas. So Puskas had spoken then because Germany had really gone at the Hungarians in that time. And Hungary at that time, that team was considered perhaps one of the greatest teams to have ever played the game, at least up until that point. And he spoke of the German dressing room smelling like a sea of poppies, you know, indicating what they were doing in the other time. And Schumacher has talked about how the German players were given injections and pills and large doses of mysterious mineral water, which gave them diarrhea. And, you know, questioning whether the team represented Germany or the German chemical industry and stuff like they were given sleeping pills to help them rest better. And Schumacher says that I preferred beer over sleeping pills because beer helps me sleep better. So things like that. But the sort of conversation around dope testing, anabolic steroids at that time and this German squad was also quite a sort of... It was something that was being talked about. So there's a bit of a digression. And after that, by the way, when Schumacher came up with this, after that, he not only was kicked out of the German squad, but also I think he was at Cologne, FC Cologne at the time. So Cologne mein bhi spot nahi mila aur wo eventually usko Turkey jaake football khelna pada. So obviously there was something there as well, because if there wasn't, then perhaps he would have just been laughed at and it wouldn't have been much more than that. But that's a bit of a side story.
I had no idea Schumacher had written a book. Yeah.
86 World Cup. On the whole, I would like to say one thing, which I should have said at the start only. That 86, for many, too many of us, if you look at the Indian fan, 86 World Cup made what World Cup is today. Before that, World Cup was not, I won't say that was big. That was big, very big. But not to the people from our side. If you pick up even 82 World Cup, which I think Italy won. Italy won, no? Italy beat, that Paolo Rossi scored lots of goals. The great Brazilian team lost in the quarterfinals.
So
if you look at 82 World Cups, if you pick up, because I am from that generation, so I know. If you pick up the newspapers of 1982 World Cup, Indian newspapers during 82 World Cup, you will find the coverage was, I won't say they were bad, but there was nothing splashy about it.
Mm-hmm.
I still remember the highest selling deli in the capital has had a good DC double column story when Brazil lost out, and the lead was something else. It was from the 86 World Cup. It really caught the imagination of the people, and for that one man will get all the credit, because television also came at that time.
Yeah, television.
And it really exploded.
Asian Games ke baad television ka
86 World Cup people. See, the 86 World Cup also made a huge impact on our side of the world. Before 86, World Cup was not that big in India. We all knew vaguely that it is a big tournament. Oh, Brazil is a great team. Pele was a great player, all these things. But we really realized it in 86. In Indian context or in the subcontinent context, if you look at it, that was the World Cup which really took us to the next level. Our football was like playing the Asian Games and the Olympics. That India did not take part in the World Cup qualifiers till 1985 itself is a evidence that neither of our officials nor our players or the fans took much notice of the World Cup. We all thought, playing the Olympics and the Asian Games are a very big thing. So that way, we should the credit goes to Maradona. We should remain indebted to him and the Argentine side, of course. Mm. that he took us to the next level. We realized what football is all about, what professional football is all about.
And so Pele, so they focus on the amateur side of the game.
And amateur side.
Obviously, it's a good one because you also because we often talk about what happened between 1960s and let's say the 80s and stuff. Because 86 was the World Cup, of course, like you said, Korea was there. Iraq was at the World Cup for the first time. So Asian countries were beginning to have some kind of an impact on the global game, and India was. As we discussed at the beginning, if you look at the logo on the extreme periphery, barely, you know, it's on the curve. So barely noticeable.
Siddhant, we never realized 1966 North Korea played the quarterfinals.
They
beat Italy. They beat Italy of all teams and was leading 3-0 against Portugal.
And then Eusebio took over.
And in 66, this is 66. 70 in Asian Games, we finished third. We won the bronze medal. But we still didn't realize the greatness of that 1966 North Korean teams.
Fair enough.
It didn't make an impact on us. Only in the 80s, when Maradona made such a huge splash on the football world, that we then realized that what World Cup could be all about.
So, aaj ke context mein
Siddhant said, we will play it in 2026 again.
It's important because aap Maradona aur Argentine sport ko credit de rahe hain aur saath mein aap television ka jo proliferation hai ya jo access to this broadcast technology ki baat kar rahe hain, that's also important because in the early 80s is, I suppose, when in India it started to really spread. And by 86, by the 86 World Cup, I suppose, people had more access to television than ever before in this country. And in today's context also, this is important because, I mean, for those of like television anchors, and in these times when information is so critical, and everyone is looking for information as to what to do, what not to do, and how to sort of behave and deal with the situation that the virus has created all over the world. The power that these television anchors and television has as a medium, you know, and why it's so important to sort of give correct and verified information and sort of portray some of the things like this Argentine squad did for Indians and showed them what football is all about, showed us what football is all about. Similar sort of sense.
Bhai, mujhe to maza aa gaya because I think this is a great series, man. Because, you know, all my life, ek to hum kehte hain football bada dekhte hain, football pe bahut zyada pyar hai. Lekin mere ko 90 se pehle, I can't recall a single game. And matlab, I can recall the highlights, I can recall someone scoring a goal, I can recall hand of God, I can recall Pele doing something. But I full 90 minutes pehli paari maine baith ke dekha hai. And for all the people who are watching our show, this is a series. Hum promises bade karte hain, so don't go by promises, but actually judges by action. Par ye pehla episode aa gaya, ab dusra episode ummeed ye hai ki agle hafte aayega. And bhai, Jaideep sir and I were talking while your internet went on lockdown, to usme we were saying ki we'll talk about that Dutch team that played total football 1974. So we'll try finding a game on FIFA TV on YouTube and hopefully analyze that game and then come together again, talk about total football, Johan Cruyff and so on.
Yeah, for sure. And so, I mean, we were saying that like many people, commentators have said, especially those belonging to older generations, older school, that 86 was perhaps the last great World Cup. And after that, because of similar reasons, because of television and because of like we're talking about standardization of players, you know, everyone playing the same way.
Yeah, supreme athletes.
Brilliance goes away and it all becomes about system and physical training, like you're saying, or supreme athletes. And in fact, I think anyway, we can do the quotes and all later. But yeah, so maybe from 86, then we can start going backwards. And like you said, next we can pick up 74 and thank you. And I guess a big shout out to FIFA TV in this time for giving us access to some of these great games, great moments from history, and allowing us to watch actually the entire sort of duration of the 90 minutes or 2 hours actually, because wo pre-game bhi hota hai usme aur half time bhi hota hai. So
can I say something before we leave to all the young kids who are watching? क्योंकि क्या है ना, एक पूरा 90 मिनट का गेम देखने की ना स्टैमिना लोगों में आजकल है नहीं. मैं देख रहा हूँ तो अक्सर लोग हाईलाइट देखते हैं या बेस्ट गोल्स देखते हैं या बेस्ट पास कंपाइलेशन देखते हैं. सो बेसिकली यू आर सीइंग द वाव मोमेंट्स इन टेलीविजन. यू टर्म देम एज द वाव मोमेंट्स, राइट? बट ब्रिंग बैक दैट स्टैमिना वॉचिंग अ 90 मिनट गेम एंड सी द मोमेंट्स दैट लेड टू दैट वाव मोमेंट ना. देन योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ फुटबॉल, योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अ प्लेयर, ऑफ सिस्टम, everything will move up a level, man. So abhi ka time hai, vele baithe hue, ghar ke bahar ja nahi sakte, uthak baithak kitna karoge, 50 kar loge, 60 kar loge, 70 kar loge, 90 kar loge if you're Leander Pace, par usse aage nahi ja paoge na. To ghar baith ke ek match dekho, hafte mein do mukable dekho 90 minute ke, and then you watch your football analysis and the way you pick up things on the field.
Fair enough. And while we are making promises, we might as well say we have Jaideep on the show, who's also a repository of sort of Indian football gyan. So we should pick up some of these games from there. Some games of Indian football also, classic games that are up on YouTube, and maybe bring those into the conversation every once in a while. So mix it up. कभी कभी World Cup की बात कर लेंगे, कभी हमारे कुछ superstars भी होते थे, उनके बारे में थोड़ा बात कर लेंगे.
Done.
ठीक है, चलो जी. On that note, let's wrap this up. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for all your insights, sir. We forgot to talk about your interview with Diego Maradona, but we will do that.
We'll talk sometime.
We'll bring that up because हमारे साथ बैठे हैं एक शख्स.
अच्छा टीजर दे दिया आपने. अच्छा टीजर दे दिया, लेकिन तो सही है.
तो क्या पता एक दिन जयदीप सर इंस्टाग्राम लाइव पे ले आए डिएगो. ठीक है.
Only thing I remember, he said that that's I will take only 10-15 seconds. He said when I scored the goal with my hand, I was so scared. I kept on telling my colleagues, come, hug me.
Yeah, to make it look real.
To make it so that the referee cannot.
Please, fair come, enough. Hug. All right. On that note, we leave you guys to it. The next episode, 420 grams, will be up next week. Stay tuned for that. Follow us on NewsClick Sports on Instagram. It's a new page for all updates on whatever we're doing in cricket, in football, and other sports as well. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.